गुड मॉर्निंग एवरी वन, माई सेल्फ कौसर मोमिन, 10th स्टैंडर्ड, सब्जेक्ट साइंस 1, चैप्टर नंबर 8, मेटालर्जी। इन दिस चैप्टर टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट रिएक्टिविटी सीरीज ऑफ मेटल्स। इन लास्ट लेक्चर वी स्टडीड अप टू फ्रॉथ फ्लोटेशन मेथड। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट leaching. This is the first step in the extraction of metals aluminium, gold and silver from their ores is the method of leaching. In this method the ore is soaked in a certain solution for a long time. The ore dissolves in that solution due to a specific chemical reaction. Obviously we are taking a chemical solution, in that we have to soak this substance in it, and after some time the gangue however does not react and therefore does not dissolve in that solution. Obviously whatever gangue particles present in that substance, they are not going to dissolve in the solution, and so it can be separated. For example, concentration of bauxite, the aluminium ore is done by leaching method. Here, bauxite is soaked in aqueous NaOH or aqueous Na2CO3, which dissolves in the main ingredients and alumina in it. So, this is the part of leaching. Nothing is there. We have to just dissolve whatever ore part is there, that we have to dissolve in a chemical solution. Obviously, if the part is there for gangue particles, so they are not going to dissolve in it and they are going to get separated out. And this is the example for the same. Next topic is extraction of metals. In this, first point is extraction of reactive metals. Here we have to discuss about however the reaction is happening with the ore substances, and whatever reactivity is happening, that we have to see. So here the metals at the top of reactivity series are highly reactive. Obviously, as we know, whatever at the top level we have seen the reactivity levels, so whatever at the high level, top level, they are highly reactive. Their reactivity decreases down the series, as we have seen the table, the reactivity series we have seen, and whenever it comes to down, so the reactivity also getting decreases. For example, potassium, sodium, aluminium are reactive metals. Reactive metals have large capacity to form cations by losing the electrons in their outermost shell. For example, reactive metals react slowly, vigorously with dilute acids to give hydrogen gas. Highly reactive metals burn by reacting with oxygen from air at room temperature. Their extraction has to be done by electrolytic reduction. For example, the metal sodium, calcium and magnesium are obtained by electrolysis of their molten chloride salts. All these things we have seen in the reactions also. So whatever reactions we have seen, that explanation comes over here. In this process, metal is deposited on the cathode while chlorine gas is liberated at the anode. The electrode reactions during the electrolysis of molten sodium chloride to get metallic sodium, as I'll show you down. So here, if we are taking cathode reaction, so Na plus has a positive charge, Na has a positive charge, and obviously the electron is going to react with it. So here we are getting Na, which comes in a reduction. If we are talking about anode reaction, then chlorine has a negative charge, so obviously with this, two electrons are removing from it. So what we are getting? Cl2. So this comes in a oxidation. So one is reduction and other one is oxidation. Next, we are going to discuss about exactly how we are getting aluminium from due to extraction process. So here there is a discussion part for extraction of aluminium. First, we will see its symbol Carillon. For aluminium, symbol is Al. Its color is silvery white. Its atomic number is 13 and electronic configuration 2, 8, 3. Obviously, valency means the outermost orbit. How many electrons are there in the outermost orbit? 3 electrons. So hence valency is 3. Its main ore is bauxite, that is Al2O3H2O, and whatever gang particles present in it, that is sand, silica, which is SiO2, iron oxide, Fe2O3, etc. In this diagram, you can see whatever bauxite, which is the main ore, this is the main ore, but in this main ore, 30 to 70% is alumina is there, and remaining part comes with the gang particles in this bauxite. Here we are having an extraction process for aluminium. Through the bauxite, we can find out aluminium. To find that aluminium, we are having two steps. Number one is concentration of ore, conversion of bauxite Al2O3H2O into alumina Al2O3 by Bayer's process. Next step is electrolytic reduction of pure alumina to get aluminium, like whatever alumina we are getting through bauxite, and this alumina we can convert it into aluminium. So we are having two steps. Let's go ahead with these two steps. Here is the process of concentration of bauxite by Bayer's process. What we are doing over here, crude bauxite getting crushed and it is coming with this container. Then we are adding in it caustic soda, which is NaOH, in this container. It gets digested. After getting digested, we are giving it 140 degree Celsius to 150 degree Celsius heat up to 2 hours. Here is that process for the explanation. Aluminium oxide being amphoteric in nature, and it reacts with the aqueous solution of sodium hydroxide to form water soluble sodium aluminium. This means that bauxite is leached by sodium hydroxide solution. Whatever iron oxide is coming from this direction. So here we are getting NaOH, which is sodium hydroxide, and aluminium hydroxide, which is precipitate. Here is the reaction. You can observe that Al2O3 2H2O plus 2 times of NaOH when the bauxite is getting added with sodium hydroxide. So at that time we are getting 2 times of NaAlO2 plus 3 times of H2O. So then after getting dissolved in the aqueous sodium hydroxide, it is separated by filtration. However, silica in the gang dissolves in aqueous sodium hydroxide to form water soluble sodium silicate. Aqueous sodium aluminate is diluted by putting in water and is cooled to 50 degree Celsius. This results in precipitation of aluminium hydroxide NaAlO2 plus 2 times of H2O. We are getting sodium hydroxide plus AlOH3. In the Hall's process, the ore is powdered and then leached by heating with aqueous sodium carbonate in the digester to form water soluble sodium aluminate. Then the insoluble impurities are filtered out. The filtrate is warm and neutralized by passing carbon dioxide gas through it. This results in the precipitation of aluminium hydroxide. Here is the equation for the same, which is Al2O32H2O plus Na2CO3. After getting reaction, we are getting 2NaAlO2 plus COT carbon dioxide plus 2 times of H2O, which is water. 2 times of NaAlO2 plus 3H2O plus CO2. When it is reacting, then we are getting 2 times of AlOH3 plus Na2CO3. The precipitate of AlOH3 obtained in both Bayer's and Hall's process is filtered, washed, dried, then calcined by heating at 1000 degrees Celsius to obtain alumina. That means 2AlOH3, it is getting washed, dried and filtered. After filtering and all, we are getting Al2O3 plus 3H2O, which is alumina. Here is the process which you can observe. After getting 1000 degrees Celsius, we are getting, after getting filtered and cooled down, we are getting alumina, which is Al2O3. So, which is the reactions AlOH3, it is getting heated at 1000 degrees Celsius. And after getting 1000 degrees Celsius, we are getting alumina plus water. Up to this process, we get. Here we have to find extraction of aluminium. In the previous method, we got alumina. Now, due to electrolytic reduction of alumina, we have to find aluminium. So, this is the diagram for extraction of aluminium. So here you can observe in this diagram, this is the steel tank, molten aluminium, mixture of alumina, cryolite and fluorspar, outlet for molten aluminium, and these are anode graphite. And this black linings is there, which is cathode graphite lining. So process is, in this method, electrolysis of molten mixture of alumina, that means melting point should be greater than 2000 degree Celsius, is done in a steel tank. The tank has a graphite lining on the inner side. Here you can observe this tank has black linings out there, that is graphite lining, which we are using as cathode. This lining does the work of cathode. A set of graphite rods dipped in the molten electrolyte works as anode. Here a set of graphite we are inserting in it, they are working as anode. Cryolite, which is Na3AlF6 and fluorspar, which is CaF2, are added in the mixture to lower its melting point up to 1000 degrees Celsius. Aluminium is deposited on the cathode on passing electric current. Molten aluminium, being heavier than the electrolyte, is collected at the bottom tank. It is taken out from there from time to time. Oxygen gas is liberated at the anode. Here is the reaction for the same. Whatever procedure we have seen, the reaction is, electrode reactions are given below. Anode reaction, which is 2 times of oxygen, obviously it is minus, and we are getting, due to oxidation process, 4 times of electrons. Electrons are releasing. In the cathode reaction, Al3 plus 3 electrons getting added with it, and here it is reduction process, which is aluminium we are getting. Al is the aluminium. The liberated oxygen reacts with the anodes to form carbon dioxide gas. The anodes have to be changed from time to time as they get oxidized during the electrolysis alumina. Like the, during the electrolysis process, we have to change the oxides as to time to time. Here you can observe the setup for the same. स्टील टैंक, ग्रेफाइट कैथोड, ग्रेफाइट एनोड्स. वी आर एडिंग इन दिस सॉल्यूशन एलुमिना which has a melting point greater than 2000 degrees Celsius. Obviously, as we discussed with the theory part, cryolite, fluspar, when current starts flowing, this graphite considers that negative. Then the cathode reaction, Al3 plus plus 3 electrons. Through this we are getting aluminium, and whatever aluminium is there, that is coming out with this direction. So this is the procedure for the same. For anode reaction, this one, which is oxygen is releasing plus carbon anode, which comes in a carbon dioxide. This is the activity series for zinc, ferrous and lead. These metals of medium reactivity, all these are reactivity, medium reactivity, and these are having decreasing order of reactivity. Next is extraction of moderately reactive metals. The metals in the middle of reactivity series, such as iron, zinc, lead, copper, are moderately reactive. Usually they occur in the form of their sulfides, salts or carbonate. Here you can observe for zinc, copper, therefore the sulfides ores are strongly heated in air to transform into oxides. This process is called as roasting. Carbonates ores are strongly heated in a limited supply of air to transform them into oxides. This process is called as calcination. We are having two processes. One is roasting and other one is calcination. Roasting is what? Sulfide ores are strongly heated into air to transform their oxides. And what about calcination? Carbonates ore are strongly heated in a limited supply of air to transform them into oxides. Here we are using sulfide ores and here carbonate ores. So for roasting, this is the equation for the same. ZnS means zinc sulfide is getting reacted with the oxygen. What we are getting? Zinc oxide and sulfur and oxides are getting releases. Here also for the calcination, ZnCO3, ZnO plus CO2 is getting releases. Zinc oxide obtained is reduced to zinc by using suitable reductants such as carbon. If we react zinc oxide with the carbon, so we are getting zinc and carbon monoxide is getting releases. Apart from carbon, reactive metals such as sodium, calcium, aluminium are also used as a reducing agent instead of carbon. The reduction of metal oxide to obtain metal. This is because these metals displace a moderately reactive metal from its compound. For example, when manganese dioxide is ignited with aluminium powder, then we are getting reaction. That is, this is magnesium dioxide. It is getting react with the aluminium. So we are getting manganese and this part, which is aluminium oxide, is getting releases plus. In the similar way, here we are taking iron oxide. It is getting react with the aluminium. then we are getting iron and aluminium oxide plus heat. Cancel it out, this part which comes in, do you know, which we are not studying. Here is the reaction given. Please observe this reaction. This type of reaction is known as Thermit reaction. Next is extraction of less reactive metals. What are less reactive metals? As we discussed previous also in the table, less reactive metals comes. You can observe here in this diagram less reactive metals like copper, mercury, silver, gold. So all these are less reactive metals. The metals of the bottom of the reactivity series of metals are less reactive. That is why they are found free state in nature. For example, gold, silver, platinum. The reserves of copper in free state are very few. Presently, copper is found mainly in form of Cu2S. Copper is obtained from Cu2S or just by heating in air. So here, if we heat with this air, then we are getting copper Cu2O and 2SO2, which is sulfur dioxide. If you react with the copper again, then 2 times of Cu2O plus Cu2S, and we are getting purely copper, and here it is sulfur dioxide getting releases. We will stop today's lecture over here itself. Now you have to write assignment. For today's assignment, make a notebook that I said to you previous also. Make a notebook and keep two parts, science 1 and science 2. With the science 1, write down assignment. Today's assignment is you have to write extraction of metals. With that, extraction of reactive metals. In this, there are two types for the extraction of reactive metals. That is, one is concentration of bauxite ore and electrolytic reduction of alumina. These two coming in concentration of bauxite ore. So this is part of your activity. Assignment. So in the assignment you have to write concentration of bauxite ore. So you have to write its main heading, extraction of aluminium. In that, number one, which is concentration of bauxite ore. So the solution for concentration of bauxite ore, which comes with the electrolytic reduction of alumina. These two we have to write with the extraction of ore. This comes in your assignment. Please make a notebook. With that, make two parts of your notebook. Science 1 and Science 2. This is part of Science 1, so you have to consider as the assignment number 1. Thank you.